bringing up. He's 19 years old. He started his company when he was 15. And he's been all over the country. And Johnny Miller, he came to me. How old was he when he started his company?
15.
How old is he now?
19.
19 years old. He's been on TED Talks, all over. And Johnny, he feels very passionate about what he does. Now, when I said a man of your word, all I do is I call Johnny up and I say, Johnny, I need you here at 6 o'clock. He go, Mr. Booker, let me look into this really quick, see if I have to work or anything else. Oh, no? I'll be there at 6 o'clock. He's there at 5:45. He's a man of his word. He's not about, and he was like that even last year in high school. So he started his company when he was how old?
15.
I didn't know too many 15-year-olds that started their own company. So give a round of applause for Johnny Miller.
I woke up early morning, put on my clothes like you, walk to school like you, long road like you, headphones on like you, same music that we both listen to, and we both sing off-key, loudly, trying to find strength, but this really ain't about me, trying to walk away, but in every way they found me, trying to hide my face, but every day they surround me. See, what I learned is really ain't about me. See, I stepped on the school grounds, they had stupid, ugly, fat, and those ain't cool sounds. Plus, my mom told me that the bad things she did as a kid ain't cool now. And when you get older, you later on, you regretting what you do now. I was just settled then, had to move now. Newtown, say I got the blues now. Mom raised me, no dad, he moved out. I'm not a tough guy, I took punches on buses, black and blue now. You wanna wear it till it happens to you now. And you team up with me to find answers, but we still lose. Maybe if all these bystanders will do the right thing, it might bring more than a change, like a revolution. Not just a resolution. I mean, not just digging up, not just revolving what the problem is, but let's dig a grave and put the problem in. Because we all know how the problem is. Suicide. The problem is, the problem lives deep inside of us all. Some let it out, some tie it up, y'all. So speak up, reach down, help out. Speak love, reach down, help out. Show our knees now, looking up. Look at what we become. Feeling like we failed and we haven't even begun. I know what a kind word can do, but I also knew what a real man can do. So, is y'all with me? Can I count on you? If you're with me, then speak up, speak out, speak loud. Speak up, speak out, speak loud. If you want to make a difference in your community, if you want to write your story, it's time to speak up, speak out, and speak loud. It's time to speak up, speak out, speak loud. 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 You gotta speak it. You gotta speak up, speak out, speak loud.
But so, this kid named David, he was in fifth walk to school. Peace.
He would wake up, walk to school, and his friends would always come to the door, knock on the door. All right, David, you ready? Yeah. Everyone would walk to school together. It came to this point where one day David's sitting in his living room, he's looking out the window waiting for his friends. But he notices his friends don't even look at the house anymore, but instead they keep walking. So David, he runs over, he grabs his backpack, all right, bye mom, I'll see you later, and then chases after them. So David, I like to say he was a more athletic, the more good-looking one than the crowd, because he caught up to his friends. He caught up. When he got to his friends looked back at him, they're like, go home. We don't want you anymore. Go home. We don't care for you anymore. Go home. You are not our friend anymore. So in fifth grade, David first felt rejected. Flash forward to sixth grade, you know. David. He's there in sixth grade. And then he's getting called everything in the books. He's getting called stupid, ugly, worthless, gay, retarded. Words that I shouldn't even be saying in a school. Words that y'all shouldn't even be saying, but let's be real, we still say it. So you can already be thinking about every single word that you've ever heard about, or any single movie you've ever heard about. Those words have been tossed in my life. I remember one day, David was, he was in the hallway, he just finished changing for gym, he's in the hallway lining up to go to gym class. And he told me that a kid pointed at him and said, look at David, he got chicken legs. So he never wore shorts again. David would get pushed into lockers. Like, I'm being serious, guys. Like, David had it rough. To the point where halfway through sixth grade, you know, he went home, locked himself up in the bathroom. And he started crying. He brought his dad's razor to his neck, put a towel over his head. And he thought about taking his life. Now let me think. How many of y'all have younger siblings? Is that a lot? Imagine that happening to your younger sibling today. Before I can continue this story, I need a show of hands. How many of y'all believe that David's still alive today? Yes or no? Yes? I feel like that's half. It's half the group. So, why I like to say David's more athletic, better looking one is because David was me. You know, my full name is Jonathan David Miller. You know, I wanted to give up. You know, I almost took my life, but instead, while I'm crying, my sister, she came in and she unlocked the door. My sister that's only 2 years older than me, when I was only 12 and she was 14, she walks in the bathroom to see her little brother about to take his life. That's why I asked. What if you went home today and saw your little sibling about to take their life? You know, but the difference is, I was given a situation. I was given a predicament. I was stuck. Like this lemon, you know, this lemon's not going to go anywhere. You know, instead, what I could have done was, you know what? Let me do nothing with this lemon, and let me just keep going on life, being that average high school kid, smoking weed every day, getting arrested every other day, just doing stupid stuff that doesn't even matter. But instead, I'm like, you know, when life gives you lemons, you make lemonade. I did what it took. I cut the lemon in half, I put it on the squeezer, and I started making that lemonade because it's easy. It's easy, trust me, it is easy for you to go to Walmart and buy this for $2. Okay. It is easy. But where are you gonna go in life if you just go around buying things?
Come on, boy.
Where are you gonna go in life if all you worry about is instead of doing it the hard way, you do it the easy way and just go to a store, buy yourself some juice, instead of taking a moment and making juice? Because my thing is, I wasn't gonna come this morning. You know that? I wasn't about to come here. Because I had so much going on, I was supposed to work today, but instead they ended up cutting my shift, which was good. But once they cut my shift, it still took me a while, because I'm like, you know what? I don't have anything to give you guys today. But that's something else trying to hold me back from giving you what I really can give you, which is, what are you gonna do today with what you have? You may be stuck in a lemon. You may be stuck, get this, you may be stuck in a squeeze. And you gotta make juice. Right? Follow me, guys.
Clap your hand once if you're listening. Clap your hand twice if you're focused. Clap your hand three times if you're ready for Johnny.
So I'm gonna give you guys a little poem today. I like writing poems too. This one I wrote just a couple weeks ago. It's called Labels. The biggest issue in society is labels. We have all been handed down labels, words that say who you are, words that people come up with to define you. There's good and bad labels, but sometimes those labels don't correctly define you. Do not let a label create you, yet instead you create the label. The issue is that sometimes we create the wrong label. If your label was written on your hand, would you still be beautiful? From the words on my left hand that say stupid, ugly, worthless, weird, to the words on my right hand, the right words that say beautiful, smart, caring, loving, that is who I am. Those were once the words I believed, but these are the true words in who I am. People may label us, and oftentimes we label others as well, but instead of negatively, we need to build them up. We need to speak life over others. At 12 years old, suicidal was the label I was facing. The labels on my left hand were those that killed me, those that made life not worth living, yet it took the friends, family, and God to build me back up. To write those labels on my right hand where today I can stand strong, I can share with you where I have been, where I am, and where I would love to go. But you see, we have all been handed down labels. But the question is, what will we do with those labels? Allow them to push us further, build us up, or tear us down? We need to make a difference in this world. I now have the label Difference Maker, out to make a difference and show others how much they are truly worth. So if your label was written on your hand, would you be beautiful? That's my question for you today. Because oftentimes people label you. Oftentimes you don't know where to go in life, but you need to create that. Right? Because you know, from instead of where I could have gone, just either ended my life or just done nothing with my life, instead I'm here. That's why at 15 years old I found my calling. Y'all are about to go to college, y'all are about to go into the workforce, but what's your calling? That's my question. What's your calling today? So here's the lemons. What are you going to do? Be lazy and just buy it?